Transitions are a big part of a video because they have the power to convey the feel of the scene to the audience. By using transitions, you can tell your audience how to perceive the relationship between different scenes and how these scenes are going to walk them through the story. So choosing and executing a transition is considered one of the most crucial parts of the editing process. Zoom blur transition is especially common when you want to transition into a closer and more detailed shot of the same scene. So let's talk about this transition and how to get it done, because there are more than one way to do it. One of the ways you can do zoom blur transition is by using lens distortion and transform effect, and then tweak some settings on them. So the first thing you should do is to find the lens distortion effect from the effects panel and apply it to the video you want to transition from. Then, to set how fast I want the transition to be, I'm gonna start at 10 frames to the end of the first clip and then finish at 10 frames into the second one. 20 frames in total. You can do this by pressing the arrow keys each time for each frame. You can go with any number you want here. It is totally based on your taste and the feel of the scene. Then I'm gonna go to the effects control panel and under lens distortion, find curvature. As you can see, I'm at the beginning of that 10 frames I mentioned before, so I'm gonna click this stopwatch icon here to set the starting frame. The curvature is already set to 0 for the first keyframe. Now I'm gonna hit the forward arrow key 10 times to reach the last frame of the clip, and then set the curvature on something around minus 60. Now I have two keyframes that mark the first half of our whole transition. By changing the curvature, I have created a blur effect in my video, but since this is supposed to be a zoom blur transition, I also need to create a zoom in. To do this, I'm gonna choose the transform effect from the effects panel and apply it to my footage. Then, under transform in effects control panel, I will go to the first frame and click here to create another keyframe. Then, by going to the last frame and setting the scale to 200, I create the last keyframe of this part. I am also going to set the shutter angle to 360 in order to increase the blur effect. This way, I create the first half of the transition. Now, let's go to the video that I want to transition into. So again, I will add lens distortion to the second video. This time, at the first frame of the second video, I will set the curvature to minus 60 and create a keyframe. Now, I move 10 frames forward and set the curvature back to 0. Next, I should add the transform effect to the video to create the zoom out. So I set the scale to something near what I set in the last frame of the first video, which in my case is 200. The reason I want to do this is that we want to start the scene with the same effects that we ended the last one on. Now I'm gonna create a keyframe here and then move 10 frames forward and set the scale back to 100. Which will create the last keyframe of the whole transition. Also, I shouldn't forget to set the shutter angle to 360. If you feel like the animation is not smooth enough for any reason, you can also select all keyframes, right click on them and choose Bezier. That will surely get the job done. Okay, now let's try another way of doing it. This one is a little bit different as the result is not a zoom in, zoom out transition. In this method, what I create is a double zoom in transition. To do this, add two adjustment layers on top of the clips. For that, I'm going to go to my projects panel, click on the new item and select adjustment layer. Now, one adjustment layer should cover both the end of the first clip and the beginning of the other one. The other adjustment layer only covers the beginning of the second clip. Then I'm gonna go to effects panel and search for replicate, and then I drag and drop it onto the smaller adjustment layer. It looks good, but I need more. So I go to effects control and change the count to 3. As you can see in this setting, one of the screens is in the middle of the others, which is intentional. You will see why in a moment. Now I have to make these edges disappear, so I'm gonna use the mirror effect to do that. Again, effects, mirror, dragging and dropping onto the smaller adjustment layer. I'm gonna do it 4 times and then going to FX control and find all 4 of them. What I'm going to do here is to change the reflection angles and then work with X and Y axis of each to one by one get rid of all the edges. Angles are set and should be 90, minus 90, 180 and 360. But the X and Y values may differ for each scenario. Just try to move and work with them to get your optimal setting. Okay, now that you have no edges in your grid, it is time for zooming aspect of the effect to be taken care of. For that, I'm gonna use the transform effect and add it to the bigger adjustment layer. This one is going to need 2 keyframes for the scale in order to work. Like the previous method, the speed of the transition is tied to the number of the frames it is going to take place in. I'm gonna work in 12 frames, so what I should do is to set the first keyframe 6 frames before the end of the first clip and set the first keyframe at 100 in scale. Then I'm gonna move forward 12 frames and set the second keyframe at 300 in scale. Now you can see why I wanted that in the middle screen. As we have tripled the scale of the shot, now it looks like we have zoomed into the full size shot. Clever. Now to get that blurry goodness, I have to set the shutter angle between the keyframes to 360. Yeah, that's it. Looks great to me. Okay, that's it. Be sure to give this video a thumbs up if you liked it. Subscribe and click the bell icon if you want to be notified of the new ones. Best of luck and bye.